Hey,
Jailendra.
How's everybody keeping? Doing good? We were just talking about the census. Who's filled out the census?
I have.
Brilliant.
And Jane as well.
Brilliant. Yes, try and get everybody to fill it out by this weekend. Come on. We've got to get in there and put Jainism on the map for England, right?
That's right.
How's everybody feeling about COVID now? Are we all looking forward to the 29th of March and then the 12th of April? Everybody have they got plans?
No, fingers crossed.
Hopefully this year we can start redoing our forest walks.
Yes, that would be lovely, Pramit. Yes, the forest walk would be brilliant. It's such a beautiful time of the year, you know, and all the flowers are coming out.
Well, I think spring has started today or tomorrow.
Yeah. Lady Nandra, everyone, welcome. Hi, everyone. Hi, Shreni. Are you? Hi, Champa Ben, Ramila Ben, Harshna Ben. Kemcho Bada, Jai Jinendra.
Jai Jinendra.
Who's joining us from Nairobi today? Who we got from Nairobi today? Hey? Anyone?
Marsha? Joining from Nairobi.
Kon Boilu? Kon Boilu?
Shreni.
Hi, Shreni.
How are you?
I thought it was you. I'm good. How are you doing?
Fine, thank you.
How's Kenya at the moment? How things? What's the weather like? What's the situation?
COVID-wise, it's getting worse. We're not in a lockdown. Otherwise, weather-wise, it's very hot here.
Okay. Well, it's still a little bit chilly here, but the sun was out. So on that very positive note of the sun, I want to welcome you all to this evening's Sri Chanda Vidyapit Friday class. Welcome, everyone. Lovely to see so many people. And this evening, we're delighted to invite Vinod Bhai to present to us in just a few minutes the topic of Pali Dana, the history and the significance of Pali Dana. But before we join Vinod Bhai, I would like to invite the two beautiful sisters, Rupali and Anushree, to recite the Navka Mantra. Over to you, Rupali and Anushree.
Jai Jinendra.
Jai Jinendra.
Namo Arahantaram, Namo Namo, Namo Sitaram, Namo Namo, Namo Ayariyaram, Namo Namo, Namo Urvachayaram, Namo Namo. Namo Loye Savasahuram, Namo Loye Savasahuram. Eso Pancha Namo Karo, Sava Pava Panasaro, Mangalarincha Savesim, Padamam Have Mangalam.
Thank you. That was lovely. You know, Rupali, Nanushree, I'm going to have to measure you somehow in terms of your height, because every time I see you, every few months, you seem to be getting taller. You're sitting down, and that Kerem board, I think, we must mark it on the how tall you are today. So you guys are definitely being fed very well at home. And it's lovely to see your beautiful smiling faces. So we'll see you at the end to recite the Manglik. Thank you so much. So welcome everyone once again. Delighted to host this evening's Sri Chanda Vidyapit Friday class. Just a little reminder that at the moment you must have seen the census coming through, with whether it's email or through the post. Do fill in the census and do put in your religion as Jainism and your language Gujarati. I encourage all of you to submit it online. It's actually quite easy and pretty straightforward. So do go ahead by this weekend if you can fill it in. This evening we have the wonderful Vinod Bhai Kapashi with us, and on the topic of Kalitara. Now I know recently we had Kalitara was on the news with the fire, and I think that is all under control now. I'm sure Vinod Bhai will give us a little bit of latest news on what is happening in Kalitara. But we're also looking forward so much to learning about the history and the significance of Kalitara from Vinod Bhai. So a warm welcome, Vinod Bhai. Over to you.
Thank you, Varsha Ben. It's so nice to see you all.
Jai
Jirendra. Namo Oriyantanam, Namo Siddhanam, Namo Ayariyanam, Namo Vajjayanam, Namo Loya Sabvasavunam. So let's begin Kalitara's Bhav Yatra, but we are going to do it in a slightly different way, a different style, because we usually attend such programs where a narrator or presenter takes us right from Jai Talati, that is right from the beginning, the bottom of the mountain to the top, and describes all temples one after the other, you know, the importance of the temples. But we'll do it in slightly different way today. Right. So, of course, Kalitara, Shatrunjaya Mountain is very important. It's most important site, pilgrimage place for the Jains. Of course, the other one I would say is Summit Shikhar in the state of Jharkhand, Bihar. And for us, Shatrunjaya, you know, we feel homely when we go there. When we see Shatrunjaya Mountain, and we see, you know, when we climb all these 3,700 steps, oh, our heart is full of joy. And we say, oh, this is something. So I'm going to share some slides. Let me do this. You can see everyone properly? Yeah? Is okay?
Yes.
Right. So, of course, we'll know something about Shatrunjaya Mountain. Kalitara, Mountain of Shatrunjaya. Right. The town is called Kalitara, of course, which is 55 kilometers from Bhavnagar in Gujarat. And 215 kilometers from Ahmedabad. Both are airports. Ahmedabad is an international airport. Bhavnagar is a domestic airport. But from Bhavnagar, it's just 55 kilometers, you know. How many steps you have to climb when you go top of the mountain? 3,750 stone steps. The climb, I mean, because there are some steps, then flat ground, and some more steps. Likewise, you go about 3.5 kilometers from the base and takes approximately 2 hours. Some people do it in about hour and a half, about 80, 90 minutes. The hills are closed to pilgrims for 4 months during the monsoon season. The pilgrimage is known as Sri Shatrunjaya Tirtha Yatra. It occurs from the Purnima day, full moon day of Kartik month, according to Jain calendar. So after the monsoon season, we begin our yatra from this day, Kartiki Poonam. Yatra Saru Chai, which is roughly October, November, as per the English calendar. This yatra is considered a great event in the lifetime of a Jain. Something more? And they were built, all these temples on the mountains. They were built about 900 years starting in 11th century. Of course, the mountain is called the Saswat Mountain. Saswat means eternal. It always existed. It will always exist. And the temples are there since thousands of years. But the proper marble or stone temple was constructed very late. So they started building from 11th century. The Turkish Muslims invader had destroyed quite a few temples in 1311. 2 years later, the rebuilding began. While some temple building activity took place under Samarasa, it was only 2 centuries later that it picked up momentum. And in 1593, Hir Vijayasuri organized a major pilgrimage to this location to attend the consecration ceremony of the temple built for Rishabhdev Bhagwan. Is the Mool Nayak there? The main temple is that of Rishabhdev Bhagwan, Adinath Bhagwan, or first Tirthankar. And after that period, the temple building was continued, and there are more than 800 temples out there. Right. There are lots of other things, but before we start, we embark upon the yatra and some of the stories, and I got some of the old documents, you know. We want to begin with one song, and I have requested Sudha to sing one song about the Bhav Yatra. So let us see. For a few seconds, I think I will stop sharing. You can see us, yeah? Right. Yes.
ચાલો બધા તૈયાર છો ને આપણે 3750 સ્ટેપ્સ ચડવાના છે રેડી એવરીવન ઓકે બાય આ ઓ ભાવયાત્રા 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 રે ભાવયાત્રા ભાવયાત્રા रे अथ श्री शत्रुंजय की कथा शत्रुंजय की कथा अथ श्री शत्रुंजय की कथा शत्रुंजय की कथा कथा है गिरिराज की आदिनाथ भगवान की कथा है गिरिराज की आदिनाथ भगवान की अरिहंत सेत सुरीश की पाठक सुकोश गाधु की पंचम गति आरूढ हुए जब गिरिवर्ते सर्वथा आ ओ आदिमं पृथ्वीनाथ मादिमं निष्परिग्रहं आदिमं तीर्थनाथं च ऋषभ स्वामीनं स्व सिद्धाचल सिद्धीवरा गृही मुनि लिंगानंद आगे अनंता सिद्ध से पूजे भवि भगवंत आ गिरीवर की कहानी गिरीवर की कहानी लघु कल्प में पुरानी लघु कल्प में पुरानी ऐ मुत्ती मुनि का कहना ऐ मुत्ता मुनि का कहना छठ फल की अमर कहानी छठ फल की अमर कहानी आ ओ ये यात्रा भाव की है सिद्धों के ध्यान की है ये भाव यात्रा की है सिद्धों की ध्यान ही है गुणी रत्न सूरी का कहना गिरीवर की अमर कहानी भाव यात्रा रे आ ओ
थैंक यू Okay, we will start with our slideshow. Can you, it hasn't come yet, has it?
No.
Yeah. Okay, can you see now?
No.
No?
No, we can see your PowerPoint open file.
Not this page?
No.
Oh, okay, just one second.
You need to just click on the presentation, Vinod Bhai, now.
Screen sharing is paused. Well, sorry for that. I will stop and then start again.
That's okay.
Yeah. How is that?
Yeah, that's no? good.
That's good. Okay.
That's good.
Right. Most of the temples which are now present dates to the 16th century. Right. In 1656, Shah Jahan's son Murad Bakhsh, the then governor of Gujarat, granted Palitana villages to the prominent Jain merchant Santidas Jhaveri. Now, to say something more about this thing, Shah Jahan's son Murad Bakhsh, the Shah Jahan, the one who built Taj Mahal, that Shah Jahan, grandson of the great Mughal Emperor Akbar. So Shah Jahan's son Murad Bakhsh, he was the governor of Gujarat at that time, and he gave the town of Palitana, Shatrunjay Mountain, and all the rights to the Jain community. Now, how did it happen? He wrote everything down and gave it to one Santidas Jhaveri. Santidas Jhaveri, Santidas Seth, was very rich merchant in Ahmedabad. He was the Nagar Seth, you know, like we have mayor. But during that time, the mayor, it was something more than mayor, a very rich person, very influential person, the person who is respected by the community and by the town. That was Santidas Jhaveri. And Santidas Jhaveri, you know, he was so rich that he used to go and lend money to Mughal emperors. Whenever Mughal emperors wanted to borrow some money, they used to borrow from this Santidas Seth. And another thing, Mughal Emperor Akbar's wife, Jodhabai, whenever she used to come to Ahmedabad, she used to stay in Seth Santidas' house. So Santidas was like a brother to the queen. And Mughal Emperor's son Jahangir, he always called Santidas Seth mama. Said, you are my mama, you know, Gujarati term. And when, of course, Jahangir came to power, he used to borrow money from Shantidas. But things changed afterward. Shahjahan came to the throne. He was the emperor. And Shahjahan, at that time, Shantidas was quite an old person, but he was still Nagar Seth of the Ahmedabad. And Shahjahan also liked Shantidas very much. At that time, one thing happened. Shahjahan's son, Aurangzeb, I'm sure you have heard his name, fundamentalist, cutter Muslim. He didn't believe in any other religion. And he always said that I want to promote Islam at any cost. So the Aurangzeb destroyed quite a few temples. And some of the temples were on top of the mountain Shatrunjay. Shahjahan, Aurangzeb's father, came to know this. He was very unhappy and he asked his other son, Murad, to repair the temples, to give all these temples back to the Jain community. And Murad, he granted Palitana villages to Shantidas Seth. So that document has been preserved. It's still there in Ahmedabad. Right. And something more about these things, about the Palitana temples and everything. These temples are being looked after by who? Anandji Kalyanji Trust is the biggest Jain trust in India. This trust looks after not just Shatrunjay Mountain and Palitana and this thing. Anandji Kalyanji Trust looks after Girnar temples, Ranakpur temple, Mount Abu's temples, and lots of other temples. So this is Anandji Kalyanji Trust. Now you might think that this is somebody's name, Mr. Anandji Kalyanji. But this is not the case. Anand means joy, pleasure, innocent pleasure. And Kalyan is welfare. So that's how this name came about. Anand and Kalyan. It's not any person. Not, of course, Anandji is person's name. You know, Kalyanji is someone's name. And you might have even heard that Kalyanji, Anandji were the famous music directors in Indian film industry. And they got this name from here, you know, two brothers. So Anandji Kalyanji Trust is managing this mountain. And since the Mughal time and after, Anandji Kalyanji Trust is about 280-year-old trust. It has been registered in India. Right. The most, I'll say something more about this trust later on. Most important temples on the hill are those of Adinath, Kumarpal, Samprati Raja, Vimalsa, Sahastrakut, Ashtapad, Chaumukh temple. How many temples are there on the mountain? More than 800 temples are there. Most of the temples are in very good condition, right? So this is only a repetition. When Murad came to power as a governor of Gujarat state. As I said, he gave the temples back to Santidas Jhaveri, and Murad even said that no taxes will be levied from the Jain community. You'll be surprised. Jain community had to pay money, taxes, for the pilgrimage, for the rice. But Shahjahan's son Murad, he said, no, you don't have to pay any tax. Right. But situation changed. That I will, of course, will go explain later. All taxes were also expended, helping the temple town prosper further. It was brought under the control of Anandji Kalyan Trust in 1730 to manage not only Panditana temples, but also many other temples of Swetambar Jains since the Mughal period. Right, this is Santidas Seth. Someone must have drawn him while he was sitting down in his office. Imagine this is 1600 something, the year was that, during the time of Mughal Emperor Shahjahan and all that. That's Santidas Seth. And now, something more about this. His son was in charge of Anandji Kalyanji Bedi. Then his son, grandson, great-great-great-great-great-great-grandson. This lineage continued. And right now, who is in charge of Anandji Kalyanji Bedi? It's a one called Samvig Bhai, whose great-great-great-great-great-great grandfather was Santidas. So they are still the Nagar Seth. They are still in charge of all these things. So the chief trustee is called Samvig Bhai. Recently, I'm talking to him, you know, because I want some more details. And I also want something more about Jainism, you know. From him. So yes, I'll be most probably taking his interview next week. But he's in charge of all Anandji Kalyanji temples, more than 1,000 temples. Right. There are many stories about Shetrunjay Mountain. Before I narrate one or two stories, let me go through one or two more aspects of Anandji Kalyanji Trust and other things, because quite interesting and you wouldn't see this elsewhere, right? The king of Palitana during British time, right from year 1700 or so, used to charge money, pilgrims tax. And since something like 1821, Anandji Kalyanji Bedi had to pay money to the king of Palitana. Every year they had to pay some money. And in 1886, the king of Palitana said, Thakur of Palitana, that you will have to pay 15,000 rupees per year to me so that I can provide you protection. I can provide police force to look after you. So some police were kept near the mountain, you know. So this agreement was signed in 1886 in the presence of British officers who were in charge of the state of Kathiawad, you know, Bhavnagar and all that area. And it says clearly that you can see 15,000 rupees you have to pay every year. So for 40 years, Anandji Kalyanji paid 15,000 rupees per year. And they signed in the presence of all the English thing. And these are the signatures of all prominent Jain trustees. And on one side, the king of Palitana and witness as this governor of Gujarat. But before the 40 years were over, this king of Palitana said, I want more money. Now that's where it is interesting. He said, I want 100,000 rupees per year. So you will have to sign the contract and pay me 100,000 rupees per year. Not only that, this agreement should have a clause in that I will charge jizya vero, pilgrims tax, every individual person who wants to climb this mountain will have to pay 2 rupees per head. Now, so Anandji Kalyanji Bedi said, no, sorry, we can't do that. This is too much. A, it was too much. From 15,000 rupees to 100,000 rupees. Very big jump. And not only that, the Thakur, the Raja said, I want to provision in this agreement that we will charge this 2 rupees per head tax. Both sides employed eminent lawyers and they requested English people, the governor of Gujarat, to intervene. Unfortunately, the political agent, the one who was in charge of the whole province, called Mr. Watson, he ruled against Anandji Kalyanji Bedi. And he said, Jains should pay 100,000 rupees per year and should pay other taxes. Again, Jains did not agree. They employed very good lawyers. There was a lawyer called Mr. Sethalwad, who was fighting the case for Jains, and lawyer for the other party. Bhaiyo tatha behno, tamne nave lakse, who was the lawyer for Thakur, Palitana's king? Any idea? Who was the lawyer? Muhammad Ali Jinnah, founder of Pakistan. He was the lawyer. So, case continued. And finally, no result came. So, Jains had decided that we will stop all pilgrimage, we'll close the mountain until everything has been resolved, everything is resolved. The mountain was closed, no pilgrimage. Everyone supported this protest for 26 months. Satranjay, no one went on this pilgrimage. Satranjay mountain was completely closed. It was a voluntary decision. Finally, the king of Palitana, Thakur of Palitana, had to agree lesser amount. And finally the agreement was reached. Jains agreed to pay 60,000 rupees per year, but no provision for individual tax. that no, you cannot take from our pilgrims. So Palitana's king had to agree. So this is most interesting aspect. And I thought, let me narrate this because people do not know about all these things. So, but of course, one very good thing happened after India's independence, that everything has been abolished. We don't have to pay money to anyone. We do not have to pay any taxes to government. There's no pilgrimage tax. Right. As I said, there are more than 800 temples on this. Some of the nice stories here. This temple is called Motisaset temple. Who was Motisaset? He was in Mumbai, a very, very rich merchant. He had a dream that he wants to build a very big temple on the mountain of Shatrunjaya. But there was no place because he didn't just want to build one temple. Some lots of temples nearby surrounding 52 deris and one or two other temples and all these things. There was no place, there was no proper land there to build so many temples. So what did he do? There was a little valley in between those two hills of Palitana. So he said, I will have this valley filled with stones and gravels and sand and clay, and I'll make a land, and on that land we'll build temples. So Motisaset Ejikhinati, little valley that was called Kuntasarni Khin. That was all filled with thousands of laborers. It took a few years, but he did that. He spent millions of rupees, and once the land was like, it was like a reclaimed land, the temples were built here. So this Tunk means the complex, is called Motisaset's Tunk, Motisa's Tunk. Motisa's name is very famous, friends. Every day, in every temple, one song is being sung. You know, when Pujari does the puja, Abhishek, Prakshal, the pujari sings few lines. And in that line, he says, Lave, lave, Motisaset, Navanajar, lave. So this is that Motisaset who became very famous. Unfortunately, after the death of Motisaset, and Motisaset even didn't survive to see the Pratishtha Mahotsav. He died before the Pratishtha took place. But after Motisaset's death, this is really a sad thing that happened. His son Khimchand Bhai lost all his money. In today's term, they had millions and millions and millions of rupees. But their ships were sunk, did not return back from China, and Khimchand Seth was moneyless. He had to sell everything and he went to live in a small house in Mumbai. That was a very sad thing. Moti Saset had built a very beautiful temple in Bhayakhla in Mumbai. Right. So this is a side story about the Palitana mountain. There is another beautiful story I would like to narrate. Sava Somani Tunk. There was a merchant called Sav Chand in a small town in Gujarat. Sav Chand Seth. Now this Sav Chand Seth was reasonably okay, not immensely rich. But in business, we can see that sometimes, you know, goes up and down, person loses his money, and he usually there are troubles, you know. So same thing happened to Sav Chand Seth. He was in trouble, no money, no cash, and people were asking money from him for all the goods they had supplied. So Sav Chand Seth was really, he had a bad problems. So he thought that, what shall I do? He knew about one name. There was a rich person called Som Chand Seth in Ahmedabad. The Som Chand Seth used to lend money. And there were no banks during that time. But these rich merchants like Som Chand Seth, they used to lend money and get some interest for that money. So it was like a bank. So this Sav Chand Seth, who was in trouble, of course, he had no account in Som Chand Seth's paddy. But he thought that, oh, Som Chand Seth is very rich. Let me write a check. Surprising. Can you write a check when there is no account? No, you can't. But he did. Because during that time, a check is hundi, just a piece of paper in which you write, please, Som Chand Seth, would you give so much money from my account, please? Niche, like you are, yours faithfully, Sav Chand Seth. So one day, a person came and said that, Sav Chand Seth, you know I have supplied some goods to you. You have not paid me any money. I want my money immediately. Sav Chand said, okay, I will write you this check, this hundi. Please go to Ahmedabad, go to Som Chand Seth, and I got an account there. He will pay you money. So this person went to Ahmedabad. He took the letter from Sav Chand Seth. Went to Ahmedabad, went to Som Chand Seth's office, his kacheri, and presented that letter that I brought this letter, this check, this undi, it was like a check, you know, the check is issued in the name of that person. So Som Chand Seth saw this letter and asked his chief accountant, Karbhari, please see, have we got account like this? Sav Chand Seth, any name? I can't remember this account. The Munim, accountant saw all the pages and said, yeah, there is no account. Sauchan said, no account, ahiya chhe j nahi. Sauchan said, thought, how come a man has no account here in my own bank? And he has issued this. Somchan said, saw this letter very carefully, saw this hundi very carefully. And he noticed that while writing this letter, some drops of tears, akhmati asu padela chhe, letter upar. Somchan said, immediately realized that someone who is in trouble has written this. Although he has no account, but he had no choice. So this poor guy has issued this hundi. So Somchan said, ask this muni, his accountant, okay, don't worry, give that much money to this man who has brought the check. The accountant says, how do we do this? We can't pay him money. There's no account. Somchan said that, no, do as I say. Just give him money. So accountant says, then how shall I write in the book if there is no account? Somchan said that, do not write anything. Just give him cash. That cash was given. That man went happily, got money. Now, after few years, after this event, Sauchan said, you know, again, his good days came back. He started earning money. Bad days ke baja rehta nahi. Business ma up and down thai. So again, he started earning money. And he remembered that one day I had sent a letter, that hundi, to Somchan Seth in Ahmedabad, and he had given me money. So Sauchan Seth himself went to Ahmedabad with the money, went to Somchan Seth's office and said that Seth, just 4, 5, 6 years ago, you gave us this money. And because of that money, you know, I could start my business all over again and everything worked out well. Somchan said, Chopra Ughaida accounts. He said, sorry, there's no record of giving any money to you. We haven't paid you anything. Sauchan said, you have paid money. You paid cash. Sauchan said, well, there is no record here. If there is no record, I can't take any money. So imagine this thing. The person who had borrowed this money or who had taken this money wants to give it back. The person who had given this money doesn't want to take it back, doesn't want to accept the money. It was like a big quarrel. One said, I want to give you money. The other said, I don't want to take. Quarrel of some different kind. Then finally, some other people came. Maharaj Sahib's advice was taken. And Maharaj said, this amount is not a small amount. It's a very big amount. So what you should do? Go to Palitana and build some beautiful temples over there. So these temples were built on Satrunjay Mountain. These temples are called Sava Somani Tunk. Sava means Sauchan Seth. Soma etle Somchan Seth. Savasomas complex. So history of Palitana, history of all this temple is really fascinating. And there are many, many other stories. How does the time go? Right.
You've got a few minutes, I think. We not by.
How much?
It's 21:04, so you've got about another 5 minutes if you want to count.
Okay, so these things, 16 times restoration work took place, right from Bharat Chakravarti's time. Right. You can see here on this one, the last restoration work took place by Udayan Mantri's son, Javarsa and Bhavarsa. In that time, he had built a proper stone marble temple. And since that, everything is okay. And as I said, everything has worked out well. So as I said, then we will take you on a pilgrimage in a different style. On that mountain, you can do 5 Chaitya Vandan. One Chaitya Vandan is done on Jai Taleti, the bottom of the mountain. Then you can go and climb the hill. You can do Chaitya Vandan on Santinath Bhagwan's Terasar, then on Rayan Pagla, then Pundarik Swami, and then on main temple, which is Adinath Bhagwan's temple. So these are the things. And there are quite a few halts. There are quite a few small dairies. You can go one after the other at different places. See, from Jai Taleti to, you can go to Rampur, Sagarpur, Vaghanpur, Hathipur, and finally Ratanpur. That's where the main temple is. And just near the main temple, Motisar Punk, which I described, Motisar Set. And from there, there are 9 different tuk or complexes of Derasars. And at each place, there are quite a few temples are there. So imagine that you are going there, you know. We are thousands of miles from this place. It's our earnest desire. It's our bhava that being a Jain, you are born in a Jain family. You know, if you haven't seen it, just take a pratigna, vow that you will go and see this. There is no place on earth like this Shatrunjaya mountain. It's an amazing thing, not just beautiful to look at it, but when you go up there, you know, you'll feel so happy and you'll feel that, oh, something divine has happened. And you will forget that you have climbed 3,700 steps. Thousands of people, hundreds of thousands of people come every year and do yatra there. You know, this temple is just, this place is just marvelous. We will end with one song. Sudha will song this, maybe half a song, you know, and we'll finish.
Main temple, Mukul.
Main temple. I don't know, I've got it here. Yeah, let me see. I might have. No, it's okay. Yeah, sing.
તમને બધાને આવડે છે એટલે જે આવડતા હોય ત્યાં ઘેર પણ બોલજો. દાદા આદેશ્વરજી, દાદા આદેશ્વરજી, દૂરથી આવ્યો દાદા દર્શન દ્યો, દાદા દર્શન દ્યો,
કોઈ આવે હાથી ઘોડે કોઈ આવે ચડે પલાણે કોઈ આવે પગ પાળા દાદા ને દરબાર હા દાદા ને દરબાર દાદા આદેશ્વરજી દૂરથી આવ્યો દાદા દર્શન દ્યો શેઠ આવે હાથી ઘોડે રાજા આવે ચડે પલાણે હું આવું પગ પાળા દાદા ને દરબાર હા હા દાદા ને દરબાર દાદા આદેશ્વરજી દૂરથી આવ્યો દાદા દર્શન દાદા કોઈ મૂકે સોના કોઈ મૂકે ચપટી ચોખા દાદા ને દરબાર હા હા દાદા ને દરબાર મૂકે સોના રૂપા રાજા મૂકે મોર ચોખા દાદા ને દરબાર હા હા દાદા ને દરબાર કોઈ માગે કંચન કાયા કોઈ માગે આંખ કોઈ માગે ચરણોની સેવા દાદા ને દરબાર હા હા દાદા ને દરબાર આદેશ્વરજી દૂરથી દાદા દર્શન દ્યો દાદા દર્શન દ્યો પાંગળો મૂકે પાંગળો માગે કંચન કાયા આંગળો માગે હું માગું ચરણોની સેવા દાદા ને દરબાર હા હા દાદા ને દરબાર આદેશ્વરજી દૂરથી દર્શન હીર વિજય ગુરુ હીર લો ને વીર વિજય ગુણ ગાય શત્રુંજય ના દર્શન કરતા આનંદ અપાર હા હા આનંદ અપાર દાદા બોલો બોલો આદેશ્વર ભગવાન કી જય. મંડે આઠમ ના દિવસે 22મી તારીખે આદેશ્વર દાદાએ ફર્સ્ટ યાત્રા 99 યાત્રા શરૂ કરી હતી. એ 99 યાત્રા નો દિવસ છે મંડે
મંડે 22nd. Yeah. Okay. So, Jai Jinendra.
Jai Jinendra. Thank you so much.
Vinod Bhai, thank you very much. That was very good.
Thank you.
There was one question, Vinod Bhai. Somebody's asked, when was the temple built?
The main temple?
Yes, I believe so. That's the question.
It was about Udayan Raja's son, something like 800 years ago. Yeah.
Okay, yeah. Lovely.
Before that, the temples were there, but the main temples was that was of a wooden temple. It was wooden temple. It wasn't the same.
Vinod Bhai, to olo che gamma je palitana no je tadeti no temple che panje gamma che ne pachi have tadeti no temple judu che ini story so che.
પછી કોઈ વાર તમને કહું તમને આખી ઘણી સ્ટોરીઝ ધેર આર સો મેની સ્ટોરીઝ એસોસિએટેડ વિથ ડિફરન્ટ ટેમ્પલ્સ એન્ડ અધર થિંગ્સ યુ નો ધ હિસ્ટરી ઇઝ ઓલસો ફેસિનેટિંગ બટ આઈ થોટ આઈ વિલ નેરેટ વન ઓર ટુ થિંગ્સ સ્પેશિયલી આનંદજી કલ્યાણજી સ્પેડી વી ડિડન્ટ નો અબાઉટ ઓલ ધીસ થિંગ્સ યુ નો ધેટ ટેક્સીસ વેર ટેકન ફ્રોમ અવર પીપલ એન્ડ ઓલ ધીસ થિંગ્સ એન્ડ British government had to intervene and lots of other things. Okay.
So we don't have a very quick question. Architecture, you know, is there any more stories on that or is it too much to talk about or is there any little, any sort of small things you can tell us about the beautiful architecture?
There are, We have got very big volumes about the Jain architecture, you know, different styles say temple banavani.
Right.
Quite like Dev Vimani style, Biju style, our style, Nalini Gulm Viman. And our Sampuras, those architects, they were very clever, of course.
Mm.
At that time, they didn't produce lots and lots and lots of drawings, less paperwork. But more concrete work, you know. So, abadi different design hati. And they were not using any iron and all these things. Yeah, it's just stone. Yeah, marvelous, simply marvelous. And how they used to do it, you know, no crane, nothing. How they used to take all the marble there, other things there. You know.
Wow.
Yeah, and that is it. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Unbelievable. Yes. Well, thank you so much, Vinod Pai, and to Sudha Beng for the lovely singing. It sort of made us all sing together and clap. And I know you can hear people's voices all over the place, but I just wanted to see how it felt on Zoom to be singing together. Even though, you know, it was sort of slight, there was a lapse of timing. But anyway, it was the joy of listening that and people participating, which I really enjoyed. Thank and you. I hope all of you really enjoyed Vinod Bhai and Sudha Ben presentation today. Thank you so much, Vinod Bhai. Next week, we continue with the topic Palitana, but next week it'll be Rajiv Bhai talking about the Bhav Yatra and taking us through that next Friday. So do join us. I now hand over to the beautiful two girls you saw earlier on to recite the Manglik before we say goodnight. So over to you, Rupali and Anushri.
Jai Chinendra.
Chatari Mangalam, Arihanta Mangalam, Siddha Mangalam, Sahu Mangalam, Kevali Panatodhamu Mangalam, Chatari Logutama, Arihanta Logutama, Siddha Logutama, Sahu Logutama, Kevali Panatundamo Logutamo, Chatari Sharanam Pavajami, Arihante Sharanam Pavajami, Siddhe Sharanam Pavajami, Sahu Sharanam Pavajami, Kevali Panatam Dhammam Sharanam Pavajami.
That's lovely. Thank you so much, girls. Thank you for helping out this evening. Wish everyone a very peaceful and a wonderful weekend ahead. I hope the sun is shining over and you get to go out and do some cycling or walking or whatever. And if you do have any questions, you can still post them to Vinod Pai at some either through email or through WhatsApp, and we can pass them on to him. But do join us next week when we continue with the